to win the lottery and score a hot babe. While I wait for that miracle to happen, I'll take a beer.
All I have is lukewarm Dos Yankees.
That's my brand. Now that's damn yucky. In fact, I think this is the yuckiest beer I've ever had. Actually.
You mean anything over there?
I'm just glad to be alive right now. I was a few towns over, you know, you ever heard of Saragossa? Well, I was hanging in the bar there. They serve beer. Not quite as yucky as this, but close. And I saw something you wouldn't believe. Now this bar was filled with real scumbag-a-roonies. I mean, not like this place here. No, I mean bad. Like they are up to no good. Know what I'm saying, Home Slice? So anyways, I'm sitting there by myself. I like it that way. Meanwhile, things are going down. Under the table kind of things. Not too obvious, but not too secret either. So, I'm sitting there, and in walks the shortest Mexican I have ever seen. He just walked right in like he owned the place. No one knew what to make of him. It was dark, too. And I don't mean the kind of dark you get when you fall asleep in a tanning booth for several hours. Now, this was different. It was like everywhere he walked, he was constantly in shadow. So this guy, short as a cocktail weenie, man.
What's that?
Oh, jeez.
He struggles at first. Then he finally gets his way into the seat, orders a Diet Shasta orange, and sits back and says nothing.
That order's a Diet Shasta orange?
Now, I wasn't interested in his drink. I was more interested in what he was carrying when he walked into the bar. Little case, pretty lightweight, but he sat that thing at the bar like it was his girlfriend.
What's the hell of that is?
Then, the dude actually spoke. He started talking to the bartender. And I can tell by the angered look on the bartender's face that it wasn't a cupcake recipe that he was giving him. He really got upset, especially when he mentioned, he said something like, beach, bucho? That's what it was. Bucho! Well, whatever he said upset the bartender. Oh, and some of those unsavory buttheads I was telling you about? Not class acts like you boys got in here, but real scum? They got pissed too. Started pulling out sporks and guns and butter knives and dirty laundry, you know, starting some stuff. So the stranger bolts out of his chair, just dives right into this case. I mean, he just dives right in like a fat kid in the shallow part of the pool. I don't know what he's doing down there in that case, but things wide open, he's down there, and he's got this thing in his hand. I don't know what the heck it is, but it's the shortest freaking pool cue I've ever seen in my life. Mm-hmm.
was going down, you just stood there like a wimp? You didn't join in or anything?
I was frozen like a fish stick, man. All I could do was just sit there and watch this, like, long-haired version of Tattoo from Fantasy Island just tear this place apart. I mean, it was amazing. These tarred whistles were coming out of the woodwork and dying much-deserved deaths. Now, don't get me wrong. These guys were no class acts like what you boys got in here. No, not at all. These guys were world-class loaf pinchers. I'm sorry, but they got what they deserved. It was judgment night in that bar. So he grabs one of these guys. The only guy left breathing. I could tell by the look on this guy's face that he was giving up all the goods, spilling his guts, confessing the world. He told that stranger everything.
Everything?
Come back, Sherlock. It's 33, 44, 22.
Better change the combination on my luggage.
Can I get a cleaner mug, please? This one's got schmutz on it.
The hell with you, man. It's the cleanest one I got.
So anyway, without any warning, without any hint or knowledge that they had altered the script on me, they now had it to where the stranger whips around and sees me.
You saw his face?
His face? No. His eyes.
He didn't do anything to you?
Not really. Because he ended up turning his attention to the scrub down on the floor.
Dwarfs! Get my knife!
The stranger sunk his cue stick through the guy's brain pocket. Then the stranger walked over to the bar, paid, then left.
So the bartender lived? The bartender never gets killed!
But, as the stranger neared the door, nah, bro. Bartender getting worse than anybody.
Here, this one's in the house. If you can remember his face.
Thanks. But no thanks. See, I'm skedaddling out of here, boys, because I have a feeling he's heading this way. Well, thank you, boys. Well, have a good afternoon there.
Thank you, Pally.
Hey!
Hey!
Give me my quarter, throw me a peso.
reminds me of a joke. Guy walks into a bar, right? Walks up to the bar, orders a beer. Says, Mr. Bartender, I got me a bet for you. He says, I will bet you 300 pesos that I can blow a snot from this stool right here to that dartboard's bullseye way over there. Now, mind you, this dartboard's like a good 20 feet away. Way hell. So the bartender says, let me get this straight. You're telling me you're gonna blow a snot from right there all the way 20 feet away onto that bullseye on that dartboard over there? Bartender says, young man, you've got yourself a bet. So he sets himself up, right? He sets himself up, he's looking across the dartboard and the bullseye. He goes ahead and gets his finger on his nose, he gets himself all ready to go. He's thinking about the, you know, temperature of the room, air coming off the ceiling fans, wind direction, all that stuff. He's getting himself, he's looking at the dartboard, boogie, snot, phlegm. He's got to deviate septums, he's got to count for that, he's got to split, he's got to get the stream solid, he's going, he's thinking, he's back and forth. Then he lets it rip! Now this guy must have a cold or something, a flu of gargantuan proportions. I mean, this stuff is flying everywhere. It's all dripping. It's coming out in a big milky stream. It's all gooey. It's, you know, five different colors. It's like tall brown, blue, beige, Band-Aid color. It's flying everywhere. It's getting all over the bar stool, over the bar, on the phone, on the bartender, you know. It's going everywhere. It's going everywhere except the dartboard. The place is just covered in snot, right? Everything's so green, it looks like a rainforest in there. It's like fern going. Now the bartender, he's laughing his butt off, right? He's 300 pesos richer. He's got sitting there, he's laughing. He's got snot dripping down his face. So the bartender's like, you freaking idiot, man. You got it everywhere except the freaking bullseye. You owe me 300 pesos, snot boy. So the guy's like, excuse me, Guy goes to the back of the bar. He's back there in the back of the bar talking to a couple of guys playing hacky sack or whatever. So the guy comes back up to the bar, goes, here you go, Mr. Bartender, 300 pesos. So the bartender looks down at the guy, he goes, what the hell are you so happy for, idiot? You just lost 300 pesos. Guy goes, see those guys back there playing hacky sack? I just bet them 500 pesos a piece that I could blow snot on your floor, on your bar, on your phone, and blow snot on you. And not only would you not be mad about it, you'd be happy. That's some funny crap, right? You'd be happy about it.
Guess what? He didn't check out. And you? You checked out just fine.
Well, I knew that I would because me and Bazooka Joe go way back.
Bucho.
Him too. And this guy, I just met him at the gas station.
Go on in.
That's actually good work, by the way. It's good to know you guys, you know, dot your T's and cross your I's. I'm just gonna... It's cool, S.A., it's cool. Lead the way.
Del jefe encuentra esos payasos. It's you!
Wait, yes, Jess, it's me. It's me.
Estás muerto.
Not yet. Thank you.
said.